Thank you, Chris, and thank you for the introductions. So, as you've already mentioned, we've been talking about the drought in California for several years now, and I think most of us were actually asked to cut down on our personal domestic water use by a quarter to a third over the course of last summer. But at the same time, we're now in this El Nino period, and news reports are suddenly focusing on risks of flooding. So when both of these topics come up, people tend to talk about them within the context of climate change. But how is it really possible that both droughts and flooding are both somehow related to anthropogenic climate change? And are we really in a period now or in an era where any unusual weather event gets assigned to climate change? Or are there some real connections that we need to consider, especially within the context of California?
Yeah, as a specialist on climate change, I'm often confronted with the accusation that anything unusual that happens gets attributed to climate change. But the fact of the matter is, we know really a lot about how climate change does, in fact, cause both droughts and floods. I want to talk about two mechanisms that cause droughts and two mechanisms that cause floods, both of which are important and pervasive. The first important mechanism that drives a warming climate to produce droughts is that warmer conditions cause more evaporation. And for water users, ranging from plants to industry to people, the question isn't how much water goes into the environment, it's how much stays there for all of the users to use. And warmer conditions drive greater amounts of evaporation. Greater amounts of evaporation means there's less in the soil, less in the lakes and rivers, and less runoff. So a warmer climate will always, as a result of increased evaporation, tend to push you toward drought. A second factor that's really important, especially in a place like California, is that, of course, snowpack is a really critical component of our water storage system. We tend to think of it almost as water storage infrastructure, but it's a free subsidy provided by nature. And in California, we have the fortunate circumstance of wonderful weather, close to freezing, even in the mountains in the winter. It's created some of the world's historically best skiing environments. But it also means that only a small amount of warming transitions wintertime temperatures in California from below freezing, when we can acquire a snowpack, to above freezing, when we lose a snowpack. And of course, the recent conditions in California, where water availability has been severely constrained, have been driven mostly by the lack of snowpack, even more strongly than by lack of precipitation. So these two factors clearly drive drought: warmer temperatures, higher evaporation, and less ability to accumulate a snowpack. Well, what about floods? A warmer climate also will always generate more precipitation at the global scale. I already talked about greater evaporation in a warmer climate. Evaporation is what drives water into the atmosphere, and it's got to come out someplace. The problem is it doesn't always come out where it evaporates, and the atmosphere has a powerful ability to move water around, so that even though there's more water is going to be deposited on average, it doesn't come down in the same places that it goes up. A second factor that causes climate change to be associated with floods is also very simple to understand, and it has to do with the fact that a warmer atmosphere can hold more water vapor. The effect is really strong. One C of warming increases the amount of water that the atmosphere can hold by about 6%. That means that the atmosphere is essentially, with warming, supercharged to be able to deliver water in heavy rainfall events. And what we've seen globally is a dramatic increase in the fraction of the total precipitation that's occurred in the heaviest rainfall events. It's not that most places on Earth are seeing more rainfall, a few are, but almost everywhere, more and more of the rainfall is coming in the heaviest events, the kind of events that can cause flooding. So we get these two mechanisms: more evaporation and less snowpack tend to emphasize drought, but more precipitation overall and greater ability of the atmosphere to hold water and deliver it in heavy rainfall events are causing floods. So you get both droughts and floods.